today is really the culmination of a number of years of hard work and dedication among researchers across UAB and working in close partnership with the Brooker people that make this facility and this platform possible. With the opening of this NMR, we provide one of the most advanced NMR facilities, certainly in the state of Alabama, certainly in the South, and I would say with the field strength that this NMR adds, we are probably here at UAB providing among the most powerful analytical platforms available anywhere in this country. This NMR facility will bring together researchers not only across UAB, but it will open the doors for new relationships with local corporate partners. We're open for business. If you're interested in the highest resolution analytical capabilities available to mankind, please join us here on the UAB campus. This represents the true interdisciplinary spirit of UAB and our commitment to our community.
I think as its name implies, the Central Alabama High-Field Nuclear Magnetic Resonance Facility is not only wonderful for UAB, but it's a significant and transformative instrument and opportunity for our entire state and the region of Alabama and the Southeast. This investment really highlights the real transformative nature of UAB and the core of our strengths, which I've described as a truly unique collaborative spirit, a strong sense of ambition, and a willingness to step out to be opportunistic and partnering across all disciplines as well as with industry. So in a short time, if you would, 50 to 40 years, this institution ranks with the best in the country because of the instruments, facilities, but most importantly because of the people who are part of our culture and our university. So that is the strength of us, that is UAB. Willingness to come across all boundaries, willingness to collaborate, willingness to be ambitious to make sure that we can transform not only for Alabama, but transform for the world, new ideas that would change the care of lives of individuals who we seek to transform in Birmingham.
This and other instruments housed in this facility are critical to the research conducted at the Cancer Center. The instruments and the expertise housed here allow Cancer Center scientists to elucidate the structure and dynamic nature of macromolecules such as proteins and how they interact with one another. This is essential to support our nationally recognized ability to take discoveries made in the laboratory and translate them into human use with new cancer-fighting drugs. This facility can only accelerate our drug discovery process. We look forward to working with Dr. Graves and Dr. Krishna and the entire team to advance our knowledge, which will change your world. It's been an exciting 3 weeks for the Cancer Center with the opening of the new renovated Cancer Center and the advanced imaging facility with the largest cyclotron in an academic medical center in the United States, and now the opening of this facility, which as Dean Palazzo has already indicated, makes us a leader in this area. So we're excited to be part of this process and thank all of you.
Now, I also want to point out to you that the NCI and the NIH grants that we received are highly competitive, and the fact that we received them is a testament to the high quality of the faculty we have at UAB, as well as the research they do. This facility is one of the finest examples of cross-campus collaboration.
This is one of the top facilities in the country, and it's going to do great things for UAB, not only for the science we're doing today, but for recruiting new scientists into UAB for the future. We're already seeing that. This has been a cooperative and exciting project that we couldn't have done it without everybody participating in this. So from the School of Medicine, from biochemistry, from chemistry, our deans, our vice presidents, our directors, all of this, it was the cooperation that made it happen.
This instrument gives you the capability for the really for the first time to look at biologically significant concentrations with the field strength and the cryoprobe. And you actually have capabilities here on this instrument that are beyond some of the older 900 megahertz instruments that are out here. We love the collaborations, and I'm again, just the opportunities for me out of UAB have just been staggering.
This is a lot about people. And I think it was 88 or 89, I came the first time here to visit the lab of Dr. Krishna. He had just acquired the 600 megahertz spectrometer. The 90 megahertz, there's nothing humble about the 90 megahertz spectrometer. At the time, it was the state of the art. The 400 was, the 600 was, and the 850 was. You have a person who's been leading, who's been at the cutting edge of NMR for, at least I've been able to follow it for 25 years. For me, this is the culmination. No, it's not really a culmination. It's such, it's a momentary peak. We're going to the next peaks. We're going there together. It's year-long friendships, and this is a wonderful, it's a pleasure for me to be here. Thank you very much.